open our lips.
And our mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Let your ways be known upon earth.
Your saving power among the nations.
We gather together this afternoon to worship God, and in thanksgiving for the 70 years of faithful service of our Sovereign Lady, Queen Elizabeth. We give thanks for her example of faithfulness to God and to her people, and pray God's blessing on her, that she may continue to fulfill the promise she has made with generosity and with joy. And so we pray together. Risen, reigning Christ, in your past, present, and future, are brought together in one great hope. Renew our faith in you, so that the past may not hinder us, nor the present overwhelm us, or the future frighten us. You have brought us this far. Continue to lead us until our hope is fulfilled, and we join with all God's people in never-ending praise. For your name's sake. Amen.
Thank you.
Gracious God, we give you thanks for the reign of your servant Elizabeth, our Queen, and for the example of loving and faithful service which she has shown among us. Help us to follow her example of dedication and to commit our lives to you and to one another. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
A reading from the Book of Proverbs. Does not wisdom call, and does not understanding raise her voice? On the heights, beside the way, at the crossroads, she takes her stand. Beside the gates in front of the town, at the entrance of the portals, she cries out, "To you, O people, I call, and my cry is to all that live. O simple ones, learn prudence, acquire intelligence, ye who lack it. Hear, for I will speak noble things, and from my lips will come what is right. For my mouth will utter truth. Wickedness is an abomination to my lips. All the words of my mouth are righteous. There is nothing twisted or crooked in them. They are all straight to one who understands and right to those who find knowledge. Take my instruction instead of silver, and knowledge rather than choice gold. For wisdom is better than jewels, and all that you may desire cannot compare with her. I, wisdom, live with prudence, and I attain knowledge and discretion. The fear of the Lord is hatred of evil. Pride and arrogance and the way of evil and perverted speech I hate. I have good advice and sound wisdom. I have insight. I have strength. By me kings reign and rulers decree what is just. By me rulers rule and nobles all who govern rightly."
Thank you. reading from St. Luke's Gospel. Hear the Gospel of our Lord according to St. Luke. Glory to you. A dispute also arose among them as to which one of them was to be regarded as the greatest. But he said to them, "The kings of the Gentiles lord it over them, and those in authority over them are called benefactors. But not so with you. Rather, the greatest among you must become like the youngest, and the leader like one who serves. For who is greater, the one who is at the table or the one who serves? Is it not the one at the table? But I am among you as one who serves. You are those who have stood by me in my trials, and I confer on you, just as my Father has conferred on me, a kingdom, so that you may eat and drink at my table in my kingdom, and you will sit on thrones judging the 12 tribes of Israel." This is the Gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, my Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. There have been so many words spoken in the last week. There have been so many different ways in which the same thing has been said over and over again by so many different people. There are only so many ways you can say thank you. There are only so many ways when you can say we appreciate and value all that you are. But I wonder what for you has been the one that is stuck in your mind and your memory from what has been a truly great celebration of the Platinum Jubilee of Her Majesty the Queen. Was it the great events of the trooping of the colour and the flypast and the young children on the balcony? Was it the solemnity and yet the joy of St. Paul's Cathedral and the gathering there and the sermon of the Archbishop of York speaking about Aintree rather than Epsom? Was it the music and the excitement of last night and the final revelation of what is in that royal handbag? Or what was it that stuck in your minds? What was it that you value and treasure? I have to confess that for me it was one of the first phrases I heard last Sunday evening when I watched that amazing programme of home reel videos and films made by the royal family, with a voiceover provided by Her Majesty herself. One of the opening statements made in that were words that have been ringing around my head throughout the week. It's about faith. It's about family. It's about friendship. Those three are at the heart of what we celebrate. Those three are why we gather to give thanks and to rejoice at the example and the service and the dedication shown by Her Majesty the Queen. It is about her family. It is about how she has supported and stood by that family through good times and difficult times, and remains clearly dearly loved and respected by all of them. But it is more about the wider family, the family that includes all of us, those for whom the Prince of Wales told us she gets up every day. The family of this nation and of the nations of the Commonwealth, and the family of humanity. That clearly lies very close to her heart and to her dedication and her service. As too does friendships, the friendships of those around her, the friendships of those she encounters through her life and through her service, the friendship amongst the nations of the Commonwealth, the friendship she has built with leaders of nations. All the tributes have said the same thing, and all who have met Her Majesty also say the same thing, that when you are with her, she is focused on you, and you are truly in a friendship with her. And then, perhaps at the very heart of it all, and the reason why we gather to give thanks, is her faith. Her faith which has guided and shaped her, her faith which helps her to make sense of the calling she has, her faith which is one of dedication and service of God first, and then of his people. The reading from St. Luke's Gospel reminds us that true leadership is about humility and service of others. And that is the example that she has given to us and continues to give to us. A leader who is there to serve, a leader who is there to be with us and to share our journey. Her faith is that which lies at the heart of her monarchy. You only have to go back and listen to the great Christmas broadcast to have probably the strongest expression of an understanding of what it means to be a follower of Jesus Christ in our world today, and how that is then applied to her life, to the life of her nation, and of her understanding of humanity. It is for all of these things, and so many, many more, that we gather to give thanks, but also to commit ourselves to seek to follow that example, to seek to mould and model ourselves on the person who we come to give thanks for, to seek to follow her example of building lives around an understanding of family which includes all peoples, to build our lives on an understanding of friendship which reaches out and breaks down the barriers and acknowledges the common life that we share together, and to seek to live our lives as lives of faith, walking with God and walking with one another. After the choir have sung the anthem, we are invited later on to light candles. As they sing the anthem, perhaps think about what it is that you gather to give thanks for. What are the moments when Her Majesty has been a light in the darkness for you? What has been a moment when she has inspired you in how to live your lives? And then to place the candles beside the Gospel book as a sign of our commitment to also bring light to our world, to be an example to others, and to share that understanding of family, friendship, and faith. prayers to our Heavenly Father. Receive the gratitude which we offer this day for your servant Elizabeth, our Queen. Send your blessing upon her work, that under her we may be wisely governed, and all people may serve you in faith, hope, and love, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us also pray for the Commonwealth of Nations, that we may always seek to build up the common good. O God, bless all members of the Commonwealth of Nations bound together under one Queen. Help us always to take seriously our great responsibilities and set before us an example of integrity and justice, faith, courage, duty, self-discipline and fairness, that we may foster the peace and goodwill that gives you alone the glory, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And let us pray for ourselves, that we may be inspired by the example of Her Majesty the Queen, that we may seek to use the gifts that we have been given in the service of God and of one another. King of kings and Lord of lords, fill the hearts of all in authority with the love of your laws and with all that is righteous and life-giving, that together with them we may be wise and worthy stewards of your gifts, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So we bring to God all that lies in our hearts, our prayers for Her Majesty the Queen and the royal family, for ourselves and those we love. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. As we place these candles, we do so giving thanks for Her Majesty's service to us all. And as we place them here, let us dedicate our own lives once again to the love and service of God and neighbour, praying together, Lord of our lives and Father of all, grant that our thanksgiving may prove itself in service to you and to our Queen, our country and one another, for your name's sake. Amen. To the living grace, to the departed rest, to the Church, the Queen, the Commonwealth, and all humankind, peace and concord, and to us and all his servants, life everlasting, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Into the world in peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honour all people.